Next one, the length of belt in cross belt drive. Right, so length of belt in cross belt drive. CBD is cross belt drive. So earlier we have derived the equation for length of belt in open belt drive. Okay, so both open belt drive and cross belt drive both are used for the power transmission between the shafts, which are parallel to each other. But the difference is when both the shafts are rotating in opposite direction, then the cross belt drive is preferred. If both the shafts are rotating on the same direction, that means a clockwise sense or anti-clockwise sense, then you can go for open belt drive. If both the shafts are rotating in opposite directions, then cross belt drive is used. So as usual, you take the driving pulley and there is a driven pulley. Let us take a driven pulley here, right? Now it is a cross belt drive. Okay, so let us take the driving pulley rotates in clockwise direction, then this belt takes a forward motion in this direction. Okay, then obviously this pulley rotates in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, and this is the direction of passing of belt or moving of belt in the right. So let us take O1 is the diameter of drive, center of driving pulley. O2 is the center of driven pulley or the follower pulley. Okay, then let us take angle of wrap on smaller pulley. Angle of wrap on smaller pulley. This is, so unlike your flat belt drive, the angle of wrap on smaller pulley of cross belt drive, it is greater than 180 degrees. That is equal to 180 plus 2 alpha. Earlier it is 180 minus 2 alpha. So theta 2 is equal to 180 plus 2 alpha. Earlier in the open belt drive, it is minus. Okay, so here, due to the cross belting, the angle of wrap on smaller pulley is increased, right? And similarly, the angle of wrap on larger pulley, so this is as usual same as your open belt drive. Theta 1 is equal to 180 plus 2 alpha. This is same as your open belt drive. Okay, so this is alpha here and this is also alpha. Okay, so this entire angle, this is theta 1. Okay, now the total length of the belt, this is split into four segments as usual. Let us take this point is E and this point is F. Right, then this point is K, this point is J, okay, then this point is G, and this point is H. Okay, so this notation is similar to our previous flat belt drive. Now, like let us take the radius or the distance between the centers of driving and the driven pulleys. This is equal to x. The two shafts are located at a distance x. Right? And what is the radius of follower pulley? R2. And similarly, what is the radius of driving pulley?
R1.
Right? So these notations are similar to your flat belt drive. R1 and R2 are the radii of driving and the driven pulleys. Or D1 and D2 are the diameters of driving and driven pulleys. X is the center distance between two shafts or the pulleys, right? So now, length of the belt. So denoted with L. L is equal to, so just like your previous flat belt drive, here the total length of the belt is split into four segments. What are the four segments? First, GJE, arc GJE. This is a curved portion or the wrapping portion, right? So GJE, since it is an arc, you can indicate in arc fashion, plus this stride portion, EF, plus what about this FKH? This is the wrapper portion around the driven pulley, since it is an arc, plus this stride portion. Notation is HG.
GH.
Okay. So now this GJE, this one, this is the wrapper portion, or this is a segment which is symmetric about this horizontal axis, right? So GJ is equal to JE. GJ is equal to JE. That means GJE can be written as 2 into JE. GJE can be written as 2 into JE. GJE is equal to 2 into JE. What is the reason to write like this? Since this arc is symmetric about this horizontal axis, so you can express the entire portion into 2 into the symmetric portion. Okay. Similarly, what about this wrapper portion on the driven member FKH? FKH is equal to 2 into FK. Shall I write like this?
Okay, sir.
Similarly, look at these stride portions. EF is equal to GH. Since the entire figure is symmetric about the horizontal axis, the length of stride portion, EF, is equal to HG. Okay. Therefore, the length of the belt, L, can be expressed as, right, 2JE plus EF plus 2 into FK plus, in place of HG, you can write EF. Okay, so these two are arcs. Then you can rewrite this as 2 into arc JE plus EF plus FK. This is what we have done in our previous flat belt drive discussion. The same thing you need to consider here.
अरे तो बोल आशा मैं आपको बोल
Right, so some of you are getting weak network, right? So wait for some time, right? So it is a common problem. Right, so now you have to find out the value of alpha. How do you get alpha? This is alpha value, right? So in the similar fashion, whatever we have followed in the open Bell drive case, you draw a line from O2, you draw a line from O2 onto the extension of O1E. Right, you draw a line from O2 parallel to EF onto the extension of this O1E. Okay, so this intersection point is designated with M. This intersection point is designated with M. Okay, now what is the angle made by line O2M with O1 O2? What is this angle? This is alpha. Since the angle between this vertical line or axis and this O1M is alpha, so this line is perpendicular to this and this line is perpendicular to this. Here there is a perpendicularity, right? So the angle is alpha here between O1, O2 and O2, M. Now, from triangle, you take triangle O1, O2, M. From this triangle, you write the equation for sine alpha. Sine alpha is equal to opposite side. It is opposite side. O1M divided by O1O2.
O1O2.
So what is O1M here? So this is, what is O1E? O1E is this portion. O1E is R. This is radius. And here, this value, O2F is also radius, that is R2 value. So R1 plus R2, this is R2. Okay, let us take, this is point E. Now O1M is equal to R1 plus R2. R1 plus R2. Then what is O1O2? O1O2 is X. O1O2 is X. So as I said earlier, since the alpha is very, very small here, the sine alpha can be expressed as alpha. Sine alpha can be expressed as alpha. So alpha is equal to alpha is equal to R1 plus R2 by X. Okay, so once we have the value of alpha, right? So you can find out angle of wrap. What is angle of wrap? Theta 1 is equal to, theta 1 is equal to 180 plus 2 alpha, and theta 2 is equal to 180 plus 2 alpha. So based on this, you can write the values of arc JE. What is JE? JE arc JE is equal to this value from J to E. What is the angle here? Pi by 2 plus alpha. Pi by 2 plus alpha. This is angle. What is the length of this portion? This arc length. How do you get length of this arc? Angle into radius. What is the radius of larger pulley? R1. Okay. So pi by 2 plus alpha into R1. Similarly, what is FK? How do you get FK value? This value. What is the angle? Sorry, here. This. This is H. And this is F. Okay. So FK, what is this angle? Similar to your previous one, pi by 2 plus alpha into radius. Angle into radius. L equal to R theta. L equal to R into theta. You will get arc length. Now you have two terms here, JE value and FK value. Now you have to find out EF value. What is EF? How do you get EF value? This value. This value. This is equal to this one. Right? EF is equal to O to M. O to M can be expressed from this right angle triangle. O1, O2, M. O to M is equal to LRHHON. O to M is equal to hypotenuse square O1 O2 square minus
O1 M square
under root of this. Okay, then O1 O2 is, what is O1 O2? That is equal to X, distance between the shafts, X square minus O1M. What is O1M? Already we have considered O1M value. Sum of radii. R1, R2 square.
R1 plus R2.
Right? Now, you can bring X to the outside of the square root. So that X into 1 minus of R1 plus R2 by X whole square. Okay, so that is equal to, you can replace square root with power, X into 1 minus of R1 plus R2 divided by X square. And if you replace square root, how much amount of power you will get here? What is the power to this? Half, 1/2. Okay, so this function, it is just like a binomial function, right? This function is similar to binomial function. So binomial expansion for 1 minus a, 1 by 2 ki ella raichu binomial function
one minus one by two into r one plus r two by whole
square. One minus one by two.
One by two into r one plus r two by x.
Plus two into one by two.
Five.
A square whole square, and so on. So this is expansion for binomial function. So these terms are neglected. These are. Right now if we expand this function in this form then you will get EF is equal to x into 1 minus half into r1 plus r2 divided by x whole square. Okay, so right, now you can simplify this as x into 1 x minus x by 2 into r1 plus r2 whole square by x square. X, x cancel here, you will get 1x, then finally you will get x minus r1 plus r2 whole square by 2x. By 2x. Okay, earlier in open belt drive instead of plus sign here r1 plus r2 there it is r1 minus r2, here you will get r1 plus r2. That is the only difference. Okay, now you have three terms ef, je and then fk. You just substitute in this equation, so this is equal to L is equal to, substitute these values, so 5 by 2 plus alpha value is r1 plus r2 by x into r1, right, plus ef value, this is ef, x minus r1 plus r2 whole square by 2x plus fk. Fk is plus 5 by 2 plus r1 plus r2 alpha value by x into r2. Okay, now if you simplify this, finally you will get the equation L is equal to 5 by 2, sorry, you simplify this, 5 by 2 r1 plus 5 by 2 r1, you will get pi r1, pi r1 plus r2 plus 2x plus 2x x plus r1 plus r2 whole square by x. Okay, so this is length of the belt in the cross belt drive, whereas in the case of open belt drive, this is the cross belt drive, and in the case of open belt drive,
So this is R1 minus R2 whole square by dx. And remaining thing is same, 2x plus 5 into R1 plus R2 is equal to N. You can belt right. This is N cross belt right. Only difference is only you will get in this last term. Instead of R1 minus R2, you will get R1 plus R2. Okay. So I hope you got the difference in the calculation of belt length between open belt drive and the cross belt drive. So this is simple. Only thing is you need to represent the figure carefully so that you can easily divide the length of the belt into different segments. And these segmental lengths are calculated from the proper analysis. Finally, you can plug all these segmental lengths. You will get length of the belt. Right? Thank you.